Hello everyone, we will now start our final session here. We have with us Dirk Steger from Latlon, and he will present us Team Engine. So Dirk, welcome.
Hello everyone, my name is Dirk Stenger, and yeah, I'm doing a presentation about Team Engine, and like the focus of the second part will be on the new OGC standard, OGC API for features. So in the title it still says WFS 3.0, but the name changed in the recent month. So this is my agenda. First, I'm going to tell you what Team Engine is, what the OGC side team is, and we develop test suites. I will show you some test suites. Then I talk about the current development in the project, and finally I'm talking about OGC API for features. So my name is Dirk Stenger. I'm working at Latlon as a software developer since 2012. And Latlon is mainly working with OGC standards. So we have the software implementing, we work with the software implementing the standards degree. And since 2017, we are the manager of the OGC validation tool. So we are mainly doing all technical work regarding Team Engine, the test suites. So what is Team Engine? Here you can see a screenshot of Team Engine. It has a web interface you can access. There you can register and execute test suites which are testing OGC standards. Team Engine stands for Test Evaluation Measurement Engine. And it can be used for several cases, so for validation of services, clients, schemas, and data. It's written in Java, and there's also a GitHub repository available. So you can check out the URL, and the complete source code is there. Also, there's a wiki with important information and the issue tracker, of course. So Team Engine is the engine to execute the tests, but not the tests itself. So the tests have to be written separately. There are two languages to write the tests with. One is the OGC compliance test language, and the second one is TestNG. The CTL language is a little bit outdated, so all new test suites are written with TestNG and just the old ones in CTL. As I already said, there's a web browser interface. Also, we have a command line interface and a REST API to execute the tests. The OGC provides over 40 test suites. I think maybe we already have around 60. The source code of all tests can be found at the Open Geospatial organization. So if you go to that organization, you find different repositories for all test suites. These are just a few examples for test suites. So there's a WFS 1.1 test suite, WFS 2.0 test suite, WMS 1.3 test suite, the OGC API for features test suite, and as you can see here, each test suite has its own repository. Also, each test suite has its own issue tracker. That's very good, because if you do not understand the result of your test run, or if you detect a bug in a test suite, you can directly go to the issue tracker, create an issue there, and we will take care of it, or analyze it and give you an answer. So we actively use all the issue trackers of all test suites and of Team Engine, of course. So this is an example how a test is run with a web browser interface. So first you log in on the left side. You can see that you can select a specification you want to test. In this case, we are testing WFS 2.0. Then you click on starting your test session. Then you see some information about the test suite. You have to enter the endpoint you want to test. So in this case, a degree web service is tested. And then you, you can add additional information and click on start. Then you can see, like on the left, there's a waiting symbol when the tests are executed. And after, I would say, half a minute, the test report appears, and it's on the right side. And this report tells you which tests passed and which failed. And if any tests failed, you can click on the tests and see a description of the failure. So the OGC hosts one installation of Team Engine, or even more than this one, but this is like the official OGC Team Engine, which is used to certify an implementation as OGC compliant. So you can, it does not cost anything to register there. If you go to that URL, you can just create an account there and run, use that Team Engine as often as you want. And then if like your implementation passes all tests, you can ask for a compliance badge. Then you have to pay a little bit of money to the OGC, and then you get an OGC compliant badge. Also, the test suites are used to certify reference implementations. So reference implementations are implementations of certain standards which are passing all important tests. And those implementations are available on the web, and everyone can use them. So you can always use those implementations as a reference. Okay, now I come to the current development of Team Engine. So version 3.4 was released in May 2019. So it's still actively developed. Currently, version 5.5 is prepared. We tagged several issues with the milestone of 5.5. So you can see which features will be part of version 5.5. So mainly, we are updating the party libraries, enhance the user management, improve the report, the final report, and the plan is to release version 5.5 late this year. Okay, on the other hand, we have the test suites in different repositories. So for all repositories, bug fixes, enhancement are implemented regularly. And also releases are created regularly of all test suites. So we try to create one release each month. And then when the releases are created, we install these releases immediately at the beta environment of the OGC. So it's that URL with TE2. And on that installation of Team Engine, you always find the latest versions of all test suites. So if you really want to use the latest version of everything, you should go to the beta environment. So, and it's the same as to production, to the official production environment. So you can just register there and use it, and it doesn't cost anything. Of course, everyone is welcome to participate. So we are using all issue trackers and try to answer all questions. There was a big update of the production environment in July 2019, so last month. So actually we updated all test suites which had a newer version on beta to the version on beta, because all of them are stable now. And so if you used the production environment before July 2019, you can you can try to run your tests again, because there are many new versions of test suites available. Okay, then Another thing is that we have a Docker Hub repository, and we provide images for all test suites, not for all test suites, but for selected test suites. When a new release is created, like a new Docker image is automatically created and pushed into that repository. So you can see that that should be the current status. Which test suites already have a Docker image, and it's very easy to use those. So it's just one command to download it and to run the test suite. And there's the URL is on the bottom of the slide. There's a short manual in the description text of the Docker repository. So yeah, you can just use that to download and start the test suite. Okay, another big thing we are currently doing is that we are want to become a full OSLEO project. So currently, Team Engine is in incubation. So we are still in the process of becoming a full OSLEO project. For that, we created a wiki page with a checklist what we have to do to become a full OSGEO project. So everyone can access this and check the current status. And we filled it out, and then we realized, okay, for some checkpoints, there are open questions, and for all of those, for those open questions, we created one issue in the issue tracker, which is labeled with OSGEO minus graduation. So that's our plan for the next month, to solve all those issues, and then Team Engine will become a full OSGEO project. I come to OGC API features. So I don't know if you have heard of this standard. So in the past, it was called WFS 3.0. It is not an official standard yet, but currently it's in the voting process of OGC, so we can expect that it will be an official standard soon. Also, it's a modular standard, so the first document of the standard is called Core, and just covers core functionalities, and further functionalities are covered by further specifications, which are currently worked on. OGC API features tries to use industry standard instead of WFS specific resources or components. So it's basically it's a complete rewrite of the WFS. It uses an RESTful approach. That's of course a concept which is used by many people, and everyone understands it. Also, there's no capabilities document anymore, but the API is defined by an open API document. Another important thing is that there's, so in the past, GML was like the most important encoding for OGC services, and that was dropped, so there's no mandatory encoding anymore, but there are some proposed encodings, for example, JSON, HTML, and GML. But I think most people use JSON to implement their first OGC API features service. Okay, during testbed 14 compliance, during the testbed 14 project, we developed a OGC API features test suite. So that was last year. The test suite is, as it's a new test suite written in TestNG. Of course, the test can be executed with Team Engine. We implemented the abstract test suite, which is documented in the specification. And there's, of course, a repository where you can find the test suite, so it's still called WFS 3.0, but we'll rename it soon. Okay, so there were a couple of new challenges during the implementation of the test suite. So yeah, in the past we had a capabilities document we had to parse, but now there's a open API document. So it's a JSON document, so the parsing was different. Also, there's no mandatory encoding, so that is a real hard issue for a test suite because we do not know what we are expecting as return value. So we just defined a couple of restrictions that the JSON encoding must be supported, otherwise the test suite will not work. And okay, of course, we introduced new Java libraries, frameworks, to make the implementation easier. Okay, and one other important thing is that the test suite is data agnostic, so you can test any implementation of the standard with the test suite, and especially old test suites often have the restriction that they are data dependent. Okay, so the test suite completely implements the core conformance class of the specification. So yeah, it's already complete. There are also a couple of optional conformance classes in the specification. Those are not implemented so far. Yeah, of course, the current release, as for all test suite, is installed in the OGC beta environment. So you can already, you're welcome to create an account and use it. Also, of course, you can execute the test suite via IDE, command shell, or Docker. So those approaches are described on that ASCII doc site. A very easy way to install and start the test suite is to just execute this command. So if you have Docker installed, you can immediately execute this command, and then you have a running instance of Team Engine with the OGC API features test suite. And as always, if you have any questions, find any bugs, you're very much welcome to report those to the issue tracker. And that's it from my side. Are there any questions?
All right, thank you very much. Please, questions? Yes?
So you want to extend the Docker image and
put it in a pipeline to have continuous integration.
Yes, so actually, so currently we are using the Tomcat image, a space image, so the Docker image does not contain the command line tool, but the web tool. So I would, in this case, I would propose to write a new Docker file. That's probably easier.
Is there a way to get the binary directly?
So we upload them to Maven Central Repository. Not for all test suites, but for most. And their team engines also upload to Central Maven Repository. Yeah. No, it's fine. So actually, you do not have to support any of those encodings because all of them are optional. this test suite has the restriction that you have to implement JSON, but yeah, that's enough to pass the test suite.
Any other questions, please?
Moment, please.
But I think we have an...
So I heard the answer, but I don't know what the question was.
So one question was if the Docker image can be used in a CI pipeline, but my answer was that I would write a new Docker file for that purpose, because the Docker images just support the web interface, and the command line interface is probably better for a CI process. And the other question was if you have to support the JSON, if you pass the test, if you just encode the support the JSON encoding, and that's correct. So you can pass the test then if the rest is implemented correctly.
Are there any other questions? I guess not. So thank you very much. And we'll be back in 10 minutes with the next speech. Thank you.